Today on Internet Marketing Pro, how to schedule your marketing. Broadcasting from the city of sun and rain off the Atlantic Ocean in Boca Raton, Florida. Good morning, good evening, wherever you may be across the nation and around the world. I'm your host, Chad Deckard, and welcome to my Internet Marketing Pro podcast show. My shows will cover how to grow your business as well as topics on tips, tricks and techniques, digital lifestyles, the future of finance, entrepreneurism, and travel and adventure. Thank you for tuning in to my show as we begin this adventure together, exploring many great things to come. If you like my show and find it resourceful, please do your social network a favor and share, like, post, leave a comment, and subscribe to my show. I greatly appreciate your efforts and support. I also want to make an announcement here now that I really appreciate all the feedback that I've been getting. What a difference it makes in motivating me to put these shows out and continually think of the next subject matter that I'd like to explore with you all. I'm also very excited about you all helping me get more subscribers by sharing my content with your social network. My weekly listener base is growing a great deal week after week, and that's the greatest payoff my listeners can do for me by giving back for my time and efforts in putting this show together. So I definitely appreciate everything that you have done and the ideas that you've put forth into this show, because remember, you are what makes this show a success. And like I have at every show that I've done in this 10-part series, this is show number 9, How to Schedule Your Marketing. I like to start at the top of 10 ways to make your marketing more effective in tough economic times. So starting from the top, number 1, find your ideal prospect. Number 2, what makes your business different than your competition? Number 3, develop a core message that addresses your ideal prospect's need. Number 4, use the ADA formula in your sales letters and direct response material. Number 5, total internet presence. Number 6, referral marketing. Number 7, connect with the media. Number 8, create a sales system. Number 9, schedule your marketing. That's today's show. And number 10, set the stage so that your employees know what is happening and why. For those of you tuning in for the first time, this show is the 9th in the series of 10. It's not a sequential show built on top of each other. It's really just all-encompassing, so it doesn't matter when you come into the series. So you can listen to the show, and if you'd like, you can go back and download and listen to the previous 8 shows that I've recorded up to this point in the archives of this podcast. So I invite you to go ahead and do so. All right, let's get into the nitty-gritty of the show. Now, in this show, I'm going to cover two parts. And the first part is how to create a small business marketing plan, because that is usually the first step before you can even begin to have a schedule, you know, to market. And the second part of the show is going to be, you know, how to create that marketing schedule from that marketing plan. Only makes sense, you know, put the horse before the cart. Let's get into it. You know, a good marketing plan outlines goals and provides direction for a company's marketing decisions. Marketing plans have 6 basic sections, and I'm going to go over those sections with you. All right, so marketing plans are useful for obtaining funding, developing strategies, and can also be an important part of your overall business plan. Although creating a small business marketing plan is not an exact science, there are 6 basic components generally found in a marketing plan. And that first one would be an introduction. You know, the introduction of a marketing plan includes the purpose for writing the plan and the organization's mission statement. Information on the background or history of the company is also included if it's pertinent to the audience understanding the business. It can also be useful to include history if the company has experienced considerable growth. Many times, the readers of marketing plans are potential investors or loan officers, so catching their attention right away with sufficient information is very important. In the marketing plan, you'll begin, you know, not only with the introduction, but the next phase that you move into in that plan is a situational analysis. This is kind of like laying the land. And the situation analysis is a snapshot of the small business or organization's situation at the time the plan was presented. This part of the plan often involves extensive research, especially if the company is entering a new market, rather than expanding in an existing area of business. The most important components of the situational analysis are the current products and target market. How the product is distributed should also be included. A list of current competitors and their strengths and weaknesses is also useful. Information on the company's current financial situation, such as sales figures and profit margin, should also be included in the situational analysis. Areas of influence, such as economic or political conditions, should also be noted in this section. At the end of the situational analysis, a summary is often used. One good way to do this is by including a SWOT. SWOT analysis outlines the company's products, strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and strengths. So, let's get into the next part of a marketing plan. That is the strategy and the objectives. This section of the small business marketing plan should address the marketing objectives and how they will be achieved. The financial objectives associated with these initiatives should be stated in clear quantitative goals. The marketing strategy and objectives section gives the reader assurance that there is a clear plan with defined measurable goals in place. Marketing strategies can include expanding into new markets or existing ones that are no longer profitable. Financial objectives are expressed in terms of profitability, sales, and actual numbers. The marketing objectives are measurable results that, like market share, number of customers, and building a website traffic. The next thing that you would get into in your plan is marketing techniques. Whereas the marketing strategy and objectives are the eventual outcomes, the marketing techniques are the methods that you used or will be used to achieve those goals. This is typically the longest section of the plan. This section should include information on the target market, product information, and how it will be positioned with the target market and how the product will be promoted. How the product will be distributed and what the price will be are also included in this section. Additional considerations would be to include are your customer support and market research. All right, well, moving on through the marketing plan, you obviously have to get into other sections, which include the budget, a performance analysis, and schedule. This section includes the overall marketing budget, including the project costs and the changes in the revenue. Be sure to break down detailed expenses on a monthly basis. The performance analysis outlines the projected results of the marketing plan and details its financial implications. The schedule is the part of the plan that outlines when marketing efforts will happen and who will be responsible for hitting those deadlines. For example, the dates of an advertisement or events and which staff member is in charge of submitting materials or working that event. So like I said before, this is why you have to have a plan before you can actually develop a schedule. And the schedule is really important. This is where the part of the marketing plan where the schedule comes in. The next part and the final part is dealing with planning because it gives you direction. So even the best laid plans can go astray by having those plans laid out in writing. So in order to improve a small business chances of successful marketing, a small business marketing plan can help obtain funding for a business or a new product, but it also serves as a written reference for where a company is going, where it's been, and what it hopes to accomplish through its marketing efforts in the future. So that is a basic breakdown of developing a small business marketing plan. So, you know, before you can obviously begin to do any kind of scheduling, you definitely have to have some type of plan to base your scheduling on. And that's why I started here. And that's why I'm going to go into the second part of this show on how to create that marketing schedule from your plan. You know, a schedule helps keep small business marketing initiatives in a priority in a busy world. I want you to follow these four steps that I give you to get your small business marketing agenda underway today. You know, because there is a limited amount of time in every day. And, you know, small business owners really have to take the time to pencil in what they need to get done and create a marketing schedule. It might seem like a waste of time, but the truth is that time spent on a marketing schedule today is time saved in the future. So pick a marketing goal. Okay, the first step to creating a marketing schedule is picking a goal. Any agenda or schedule is worthless without having something to achieve. A small business marketing goal is a great place to start. Begin with imagining a month. Within this month, consider what marketing goals need to be accomplished. How do they relate to the bigger picture, like quarterly goals, yearly goals? Breaking these long-term goals into smaller pieces, such as months, make them less intimidating, and then it's easier to figure out which tactics to use to meet these goals. Common marketing goals might include social media, where you can get a certain amount of members or followers each month. Email marketing, increase conversion rates of the email performance with an email test plan. Direct mail, use direct mail to acquire X amount of new customers a month. Surveys, increase revenue by using customer feedback from surveys. PR, write one press release a month to get media coverage and build buzz around your business. And select a marketing calendar. You need to now, at this point, choose a calendar for your marketing schedule. Step two is simply to pick a calendar on which to make your small business marketing schedule. There are many free and easy ways to create a marketing schedule. Most email services offer calendars like Google Calendar. One can even get organized by creating a plan in Microsoft Word or Excel, which is what I do. And so once you've decided on what type of calendar or way that you, or I would say medium or way that you're going to record and follow your plan, you might want to get into beginning to start scheduling. And to start scheduling, you want to start off by scheduling on a micro basis by the day. So I would say the third step involves making a list of activities and responsibilities that will help your business reach your marketing goals. And here are some ideas to start with in scheduling on a day-by-day basis that would go for the weekly, to the monthly, to the quarterly, to the annual basis. So you want to build from the small micro to a more macro view. And that's what we'll pull it all together, is taking one step at a time and building upon it. So here are those ideas. Social media. You might want to create a social media accounts and then a lot of times for blogging, posting, and tweeting them. Email marketing. Create an email test plan with content due dates and launch dates. Direct mail. Pick a method of direct mail to try. Postcard, flyer, letter, etc. Then decide on which dates, the due dates, and which are the launch dates to drop that mail. Surveys. Make time to discuss survey ideas. Schedule time to write the questions and pick survey send dates. PR. Have a PR check-in. Allow time to explore good media sources. Delegate time to write press releases. Allot dates to send out those releases. Reporting. Be sure to allow time to stay on top of your reporting, because that's really important to see what your report card tells you, how you're doing and what you're doing and whether you need to make corrections very quickly or not. You know, the other thing you can do is industry review. Hold industry reviews and news and trends and best practices to catch up on. I've talked about this in previous episodes. I believe it was episode number 5 where I said total internet presence. And some of these ideas that I just presented to you are relative to the total internet presence. That's why all these shows kind of interrelate to each other. So you will want to take your total internet presence that we've discussed in the past and work around the different aspects of that total internet presence and, you know, developing a schedule for your marketing. With that in mind, we need to now think about, okay, here's a general idea of our marketing. Now we have to think about its frequency. And we need to decide which of these particular points, like social media, email, direct mail, survey, etc., which of these need to be conducted daily, weekly, or monthly, or quarterly, or yearly. And then we need to enter those activities on a monthly marketing calendar where they need to be. Cut, paste, and repeat all the activities that need to occur more than once and start laying those particular things out. So if an email needs to go out 3 times a week on Monday, Wednesday, Friday, then go to every Monday, Wednesday, Friday for the next 52 weeks and just, you know, on your calendar, a lot of them have features where you can say it's repetitive. You know, and you click the box and it will put down like 8 o'clock every Monday. And you can say for the next year or whatever, 2 years or 5 years, whatever you want, on a Monday, that particular thing is scheduled between 8 and 8:30. So that schedule is important that you can use those features in some of the really cool, like Google Calendar and other types of, I think Lotus has something from the past, and there's some other calendars that have that ability to be able to automate and duplicate your, say, a single day scheduling over the course of time without you having to go to 500 different or 365 days and put something in each one of them individually for every single day. Here's a fun scheduling tip. List all the small business marketing ideas to try. Now cross off the ones that are too ambitious, expensive, or aren't effective enough. Then prioritize the remaining items and add them to your plan. So this is kind of a wish list of, you know, the big idea or the one big marketing thing, like, hey, we're going to advertise in the Super Bowl commercials and I think we're going to, you know, get wealthy or get a lot of exposure for that, even though I wouldn't personally do that unless I had a super brand. And we've already, you know, dot-coms have already had that experience in the late 90s, blowing a lot of money on Super Bowl commercials, obviously proving that it didn't work. So take the time to think about what your wish list is and trying some maybe some new things that you haven't tried before in the past to expand your reach and audience. Decide on which ones would be the most relative and ideal to do at this time. And, you know, put the ones that are a little bit too ambitious or expensive on the back burner, that if these, I say, more relevant ones to at the point of where you are right now, work, then you can work towards those ambitious and more expensive ones later on down the road once you've proven what you're doing now works and you've earned it. Okay, it's all laid out now. And, you know, I'd say step four is just simply execution. And really, the easiest thing to do is just stick to the schedule. You've heard it, just stick to the plan. The daily, the weekly, the monthly breakdown is essential. And a to-do list is designed to keep small business marketing plans on track. So take into consideration the new marketing schedule and get to work. So that's about it for this show. If you like my show, please consider subscribing to it, which you can do by visiting my website, chaddeckard.com or ezinegenerator.com. If you are an iTunes or Stitcher Smart Radio listener, take it with you wherever you go on your mobile device. If you like my show and find it resourceful, please do your social network a favor and share, like, post, leave a comment, and subscribe to my show. I greatly appreciate your efforts and support, and you are part of what makes this show a success. Well, that's about it for this show. Good morning, good evening, wherever you may be. Across the nation and around the world, this is Chad Deckard signing off. Goodbye for now.